Hello guys, thank you for watching a new episode of DYC. In today's episode we will be reviewing a new tool from Toolkit RC, a watt meter that goes to 150 amps and can handle 50 volts. It is up from 1S LiPo battery up to a 12S battery, and that's crazy amount. Definitely if you're planning to build a drone or an RC plane this winter, I definitely can guarantee you that you will need this little tool, because with 150 amps you can plug it into most drones, and you maybe want to like to try out a different propeller on your drone with a different pitch, maybe a different blade, maybe from 2-bladed to 3-bladed, or from 3-bladed to 4-bladed. You will get a different load, and you don't want your little motor to draw more amps than your EC can handle, because one of them will go up in smoke. And this little device will show how much amps your drone is pulling. You don't have to test one motor at this time. You can test all four motors together with a 100 to a maximum of 150 amps. But you can also test just one motor with an EEC. You do have to supply power to this side, to the source, and the load to the EEC will go on this side. I do have to solder my own XC60 connectors to it to make it work. And let's do that first so we can show you how it works. And I want to thank Hobby Powder for sending this to review. You will find the links down below. And just to explain all the information that you get to see on your LCD screen is that you get the amp meter here. You got the same amp meter in a graphic way down below. You get the watts. Here's your throttle. Here's the voltage of the battery that you're using. Here are the milliamps capacity that you're using, and the time. And you got a USB connection, so you can connect it to your PC and you can update the firmware and unlock new functions. And there's already a new firmware update available, will be linked up over here and coming up in the next video. So if you're new to this channel and you like this, please subscribe and click the notification bell so you'll be notified when the next video will be released. Thank you very much. And let's continue the test. Here's all the XC60 connectors. We connected the battery. We connected the EC to the watt meter from Toolkit RC. We are using a 22A12 AD motor with a 9x50 prop and a 30 amp EC. And in my guess always was that it was using around 20 amps. So let's go ahead and do a test. As you can see, with a half full battery, it's just 11.5 volts. And that's just to be on the safe side, to really see how many amps we draw and not going over the 30 amps that the EC is rated for. And then we're gonna change out for a full battery and do the test again. But the first step you have to do with the new motor and EC being connected is having full throttle up. So you put the knob full throttle. We connect the motor. We connect the servo. And you can see the servo EC comes without a BSC. The white one is signal and the ground is black. Let's connect that. And then when the throttle is fully up, we connect the battery. And we're gonna put the source together. And this battery, like I said before, is only half full to be on the safe side. We wait until it finishes that song for half. Now we just turn it to minimum throttle and then it continues the song. And then the EC throttle is calibrated. And the next time you give throttle, it starts spinning. And I've always been very curious on how much amps this motor and prop setup draws. I just used 30 amps because to be on the safe side. Let's start up the throttle. Only 3 amps. The maximum was only 30 amps, so I can do with a 20 amp EC easily. And that's also because it's just a battery that is half full. Now you will see with a full battery, with more voltage, you will get more speed, and that will create more drag, and therefore also more amps, using the same exact battery, but then fully charged. And the EC is already calibrated. Now you can see it's 12.5 volts. So it's 99% fully charged. And now let's do the test again. Let's see what happens. Again, 3 amps. Now it went up to 16 amps. That's a lot higher than with a half full battery. Just like I expected. And crazy amount of trust because my whole plateau went flying. Well, that was a great test. I really like the machine, how it works, how it showed the amps in numbers as well in a graphic. And the watts, and now I was able to tell for definitely sure that I can go to a 20 amp EC instead of using the 30 amp EC that I just used to be on the safe side. And now I can use that 30 amp EC for one of my other products, for my drones that are coming up in this winter that I'm going to build. So we'll be using this little machine many times and testing a lot of different motors. So you already got a sneak peek of what is coming up in this channel in the future this winter. And if you're liking this little toolkit from Toolkit RC, then check out the links down below. I can definitely recommend for everyone that is building their own drones, planes and boats. You will definitely want to have this in your toolkit box. And get my thumbs ups. And I want to again thank Hobby Porter for sending it to review. And I hope that everyone that is new, like and subscribe. And I hope to see you next time. This is DIYRC signing out. Goodbye. Here's your throttle.